Philippine Competition Commissioner Chairman Arsenio Balisacan has no issue with the World Bank's recent assessment of the state of the Philippines, with the number of monopolies, duopolies, and oligopolies in Philippine manufacturing exceeding that of comparable economies, and Philippine government-owned and controlled corporations, or GOCCs, acting as barriers to entry in other non-infrastructure sectors. Balisacan has actually been working on something to help the PCC rectify the situation with the National Economic and Development Authority, the National Competition Policy, which he hopes will be executed by no less than President Rodrigo Duterte via executive order.
Would be approved. That will really simplify a lot the processes and the work of the commission, because it will give a platform for the commission to sit down with the agencies so that we can resolve these potential conflicts instead of us quarreling about jurisdictions.
In its latest Philippine Economic Update published Thursday, the World Bank reduced its growth outlook for the Philippines from 6.4% to 5.8%. The delayed passage of the 2019 budget and the ban on construction projects due to the midterm elections were listed as the main reasons for this downgrade. But a lack of competition in the Philippines was also cited as a key hindrance to growth. The World Bank, however, stopped short of criticizing the PCC, which is tasked with cracking down on anti-competitive behavior.
They're doing a very good job, but it's just to be mindful that it's a new agency. They have more things to do that they have the capacity to deliver.
World Bank also noted some state-owned enterprises, or GOCCs, are also hindering competition, especially when such GOCCs play a regulatory role on top of actually participating commercially.
Why they are in the market and what kind of service they are providing to the society that cannot be fulfilled by the private sector. And also they are, I think, not only in the competition perspective, because some of the SOE, they do incur a loss.
The World Bank, however, noted it lacks the data needed to pinpoint which GOCCs should be privatized or rationalized. Balisacan agrees with the rationale, but sorting out which GOCCs are hurting competition does not fall under the PCC's mandate.
I think it's proper that government should revisit the mandate, the objectives of these GOCCs, whether they are still relevant and whether they are standing in the way of growth for certain markets. BOF, for example, is and DBM have been quite strong of the view that that we need to justify the rationale of existence for these GOCCs.
Balisacan says government has succeeded in rationalizing some GOCCs, such as the National Food Authority, through the rice tariffication law, but he agrees more is needed. The Governance Commission for GOCCs is the agency in charge of this space. The Duterte economic team has also recently pitched the privatization of the commercial operations of the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation and the Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.